I don't know how far you could throw a dime, but there is no way he punts. No one punts the ball in this game. They call a punt, and then they call a fake punt right afterwards, and they get the first down. God damn it, why do we give up a first down? Hard to believe you can structure a team built around players that are not playing their normal positions and go 2-0, but that is what we are doing, and not only doing 2-0, we're going to try to go 3-0 today with Hester at cornerback, with Edelman at quarterback, with J.J. Watt at tight end.
Tick-tock.
He's barely going to get this playoff. No matter what he does, he cannot really adjust it. If he runs a pitch, we're just going to fly to the outside. He is just running right side, which is actually a bad thing. Thankfully, we have Ronnie Lott to stop AP. I don't know if this is part of this guy's strategy or not, but it is taking him quite a while to pick his plays. I don't know if that's by design or not, but doesn't seem too smart. All right, I think he's passing the ball here. Yes, he is. He is just throwing it in the flats to the fullback, who we are going to crush if he keeps on doing that. All right, third down, running a pitch to the outside. Got to get there with Calvin. Got him. Stop short. All right, what are we feeling here? Four verts. Yeah, I don't think he goes straight to four verts on fourth down. I think he's feeling the drag routes, recovering the running back. He's going backward, but he's got the first down. He's probably going to want to run the ball on first down. That's normally the MO. Run a little bit inside zone, try to get something going. But we're not going to give him that. We're going to cover the middle and force him to throw it to Steve Atwater at linebacker. Stutter step in the end zone. Touchdown. I noticed on the last kickoff this guy did that was very abnormal is he has Darrell Revis returning his kicks. I don't know what the reason for that is, because you don't think kick returner when you think of Darrell Revis. A pitch to the right side is the move here, and apparently it is. I don't think that's working out too well though. You guys gotta learn that the pitch is not the move. Oh, screen pass is not the move either. Oh, AP, we're gonna track him down. Gang tackling, that's what I'm talking about. We don't have one great tackler on this team, but we just throw bodies. Eventually someone's gonna bring down the running back or whomever it is. Oh, what do we got here? We got something in the middle. Something in the middle that we are covering is definitely going through the depth chart, which I can only imagine is like the biggest WTF to this guy. Like, what idiot is running an all-out-of-position team and beating me right now? Has he got a 4th and 20? See what we got on 4th down. I'm thinking it might be a screen pass, which is an easy touchdown for us. Antonio Gates normally catching passes from Phillip Rivers. Oh, that might be it. That might be it. Oh, Bridgewater is the one that threw that dime to Teddy, or to Antonio Gates. Is he out of here? Everybody wants kung fu fighting. Oh no, that's a catch. You got. Oh, come on, man. We really let that happen? Really, man? We just lit up a lob streak to Ladarius Green? We're pretty trash for that. Come on, guys. It's hard to believe it's been the first quarter. We're up 14-0, but this is our first offensive play of the game. Here, just gonna feel out the defense a little bit. Gonna stall. Oh, almost spun it with Cam. Yo, Cam, chill. You actually lost us a yard there. All right, we're just lobbing it up to Dion. This is an easy touchdown. I probably possessed and catch that by accident, but go get it, Dion. I have a pretty good feeling we're going to be seeing some man coverage here, which means J.J. Watt should get his fair shake at the end zone. Almost got it. Got to the 1 yard line. And we are in for the touchdown with Edelman. I know he's trying to hit. Oh, he's just going into double coverage. Oh, Buchanan. All right, big third down here. Let's see if he tries to throw a drag route. Going nowhere, getting sacked. Bring up fourth down. No way he punts this ball. I don't see it for the life of me. Now, he has a bronze punter, so I don't know how far he could throw a dime, but there is no way he punts. No one punts the ball in this game. They call a punt, and then they call a fake punt right afterwards, and they get the first down. God damn it, why do we give up a first down? We are going to that same tight end streak as before. He's just squeezing it in and taking it to the 5 yard line. All right, so he's putting together a productive drive after our blunder on special teams. I probably should have just called a play instead of being a little bit stubborn, but yeah, whatever. We'll live with the results here. Hopefully, we can just get a goal line stop. Let me get to Calvin really quick. Let me Let me pick that off with someone, please. There's no way he's still running the pitch. He's still running the pitch. He hasn't learned that we are all over his pitch today. All right, I'm a little bit pissed off that we gave up that freaking fake punt. So I'm trying to make sure we do not give up a touchdown, especially on that kind of play that probably should have been picked off. All right, fourth down and goal play action. Probably going to the outside in the flats. Got the touchdown to the fullback. You don't see that one every day. Good play by him. I just really didn't think he would throw it to the fullback. Probably going to come out in a cover four again. So we are just going to throw a little screen pass. Why not? Let Cam get some blocks. Hit a spin. Newton got the first down. That's what we needed right there. Call timeouts. We got plenty of time to take this in the field goal range. And this is where the live commentary portion of the video ends, unfortunately. We got some post-com for the rest of it. Don't worry. There's definitely some great plays you guys got to check out in this one. But right now, you see I'm trying to pause the game because I had to end the live commentary. But you're not able to pause when a play is about to happen. So we just got to let the show go on with 26 seconds left before half. Dumping it down to Deion Sanders. Hitting the spin move and tackled. So elusive he is, but unfortunately we have to call our second timeout with 19 seconds left. You see he's offside, so we just snap the ball really quick, and even though we get sacked, it's going to be first down and 5. Unfortunately, that did take up like 4 seconds of the clock. So we're trying to get the ball in field goal range. Gonna try to hit JJ Watt on the slant. That's what we do, and Watt takes the ball out of bounds all the way to the 28-yard line. So now with a timeout in our back pocket, we're gonna try to take a shot in the end zone, but nothing is open. So we're gonna leave the pocket with Julian Edelman, and Edelman with the clock winding down. Oh, Edelman, touchdown! What a play by Julian Edelman. A risky play, fantastic. If we got tackled in bounds, we probably don't get any points on that drive because we got tackled at the 1 yard line. The clock would have probably dwindled down before we could call our final timeout. So that was just a ballsy decision to juke inside. I was just feeling it. That's just classic Julian Edelman football, though. Normally, he does it as a punt returner or a wide receiver, not as a quarterback. You see, we try to run the flea flicker out of halftime here. He onside kicked the ball down 14. He probably felt a little bit desperate, and thankfully we were able to recover. And even if we didn't, he got called for a penalty anyways. You guys see third down and 3, gonna pass the ball, but it's incomplete. On fourth down, we have a decision to make here, and we go with the safe option. Take our field goal, make it a 3-possession game, and rely on our defense to win this game. I feel, you know, confident that we could get the first down on fourth down and 3, but I'm more confident in our defense that we could force him into another mistake. Now, he's gotten 2 touchdowns on like a lob streak and then a fake punt drive, so we just gotta make sure we guard that kind of stuff, the easy stuff. Make him work for it, and, you know, I think we can force him into a mistake because he has been making quite a few of those. You guys see, he's looking to take a few deep shots. Ladarius Green, back-to-back catches for him. We got to watch number 89 for the rest of this drive. He's already moved the ball quickly to the 37-yard line, taking a shot, but Ronnie Lott is able to punch that ball loose, and it was almost picked off. You see, he's got to score quickly. It's probably 4-down territory, so he's just chucking up streaks. End zone, picked off! Calvin Johnson keeps both feet in bounds. Spectacular interception by Megatron. Calvin was, he got beat. He had a step on me. See, the game starts lagging very badly at this point, but Calvin Johnson, that spectacular one-handed catch and stays in bounds. That is why you use her with a free safety Megatron. That's why he's just worth having on your team. Just so funny to see JJ Watt. Unfortunately, this guy was trying to lag the game. I don't know if he was trying to get us to lag out of the game or what, but this game got very choppy for the most part. You guys see we're just running the ball with Cam Newton. Now, the one thing about lag, don't worry, this is not your computer. This is definitely the game that I was in. But yeah, the one thing about lag is that you can see the running lanes, like the rushing lanes, a little bit better. You see, I'm hitting all these jukes with Cam Newton, planning out my moves before they even happened. That time, I just absolutely chucked the defender with Cam. So with this game lagging, I just want to make sure like we don't get lagged out of the game like we did before in that other salary cap ring game when it was about to go to overtime as we get hit before we could like lose the screen pass. But yeah, I'm just trying to put on shoe clock, try to get this game over with. We're faced with another 3rd down and 3. We're going the same play we did before, and once again, it doesn't work because this time Charles Woodson drops the ball. And even though we're at a 4th down and 3, I don't know if this guy lagged himself out of the game. I don't know if he rage quit. Kind of a weird time to leave the game, but your connection to your peer has been lost. Now, thankfully, we do end up with the win in this game. So, Julian Edelman, Calvin Johnson, a lot of great plays. The Antonio Gates pick 6, the Atwater pick 6. Felt like every touchdown we had was just a big, big play. So, leave a like on this video if you guys enjoyed it. Subscribe for more Madden 16 Ultimate Team. The out-of-position team is now 3-0. You guys will see eventually that thankfully they gave us a win this time. And I sent a message to this guy after the game because I'm pretty sure he was trying to just lag the game. That's usually what people do when they go down a lot. want to try to like lag the game, try to make you quit or something, or make you force yourself to lag out. So I sent him a pretty brutal message. I think he deserved it though. But we want a video. You guys enjoyed it. Subscribe for more, and I'll catch you guys next time.